Hello everyone, I'm Ryan211 and I'm going to show you how to properly install Payday 2 mods. I say properly because not all videos on YouTube might be as clear and a lot are also outdated. First let's go to our game folder. By default it's on your C drive, which is your system drive. Have you set a custom location, then you need to go there. I will show that in a second. If you have not changed the path, it's on your system drive. Mostly C, then program files, you go to Steam, then to Steam apps, common, and then here you find the game folder. Have you set a custom location and do you not remember where it is? Then you go to your library, you right click Payday 2, then you go through properties, local files, browse local files, and then you get the same spot. Now we're in the game folder, we can start. First of all, let's not open Firefox, let's open Chrome. First of all, let's get a mod that has no requirements, the mod override type. So let's take one of my mods, because I know those. Battle Royale. This is my mod. This is a override format mod. Those do not have any requirements and can easily be installed. How are those installed? Well, you go into your assets folder, and then the folder has no subfolders by default. This folder is from completing the secret end. This is one I made myself. When you are installing mod overrides mod, you need this folder. The game will recognize this folder without you needing any mods. If it's not there, you create this folder and call it mod lower score overrides. Now you go into that folder and you just move the folder in here to open these files, which are commonly .raw, .zip, sometimes they are 7-zip files. You need either WinZip, WinRAR, or 7-zip. I recommend WinRAR, though it has irritating pop-ups, but WinZip has a very irritating user interface, and 7-zip is not really friendly for all types of extensions, while WinRAR is more commonly compatible with all sorts of files. Then we have the other types of mods. Those are the Lua mods, which cannot be put in the mod override folder. So let's see this mod. It's recognizable by requires BLT or the Lua tag, which can never be put in mod overrides unless it's a music mod, which I will show later. So you have two options. You can go download BLT 2 for Payday 2. You see here paydaymods.com has it. Generally this is not a good option. Why? Because you also have SuperBLT. SuperBLT is an alternative which has better support for Windows 10. BLT 2 might not always work on Windows 10, and because it supports newer mods like custom weapon mods and the kind of stuff that BLT 2 cannot do since it hasn't been updated in a while. Generally you would want to download SuperBLT unless you do not use any SuperBLT mods and are not planning to do so, as BLT 2 is slightly lighter. If you have a very low end computer, you probably don't want SuperBLT, as it might give a difference of 1 or 2 frames per second, and if you play at 12 frames per second already, then it's not nice. So then how to install it? I will show it here. This driver, by the way, it will most likely be already installed, but if you ain't sure, you might want to check this. So you just download the DLL file. Go into your game folder, the main game folder, and you move the DLL file here. Now I've already have it, of course. If you're upgrading from BLT 2, There's a file here, which is a file with this name. You might want to remove that file, as it won't work if you have WSOC 32 and that file. So if you have that file, you'll need to remove it. And like it already mentions here, you need to go in your mods folder and remove this folder, because if you have used BLT2 before, this folder is filled with BLT2 data. If you use SuperBLT, it will also create this folder, but if you use BLT2 before, then you need to remove it. Then, how do you install it? Well, very simple. You download it, you open it with your archiver, you go to mods, and you simply drag it in. And that's basically all. How do you know something is a Lua mod? Well, it's pretty recognizable. If it says requires BLT, it's always a mod that goes in mods. Does it say retexture? Then that's probably a mod override mod. Music mods are often mods used with BeardLib, which is a mod. And if you install that mod, you can put music in mod overrides. If you do not see any tags, you can go inside the folder, and if you find a mod.txt file, you know that it's a mod that's supposed to go in the mods directory. Do you not see one, and do you also not see a main.xml file, then you know for sure it has to belong in mod overrides. The main.xml file is a file that can be used by mods that depend on other mods, but if you only use BLT, that's not gonna happen. That's basically all. I hope you now understand how to properly install mods.